Hey guys, Robey here, and I know you might be thinking that I'm dead, but I'm not. I'm back, baby, with some Divi tutorials to help you enrich your Divi websites with the power of Divi and, on occasion, some of our plugins, your Divi engine. And I'm excited to get going with this again and show you guys how to do some cool stuff. And today it's going to be down to adding some excellent particle effects when you click on buttons within the Divi theme. I'm going to show you three different ways to add it. We're going to be adding it to a button module. We're going to be adding it to a Divi contact form module. And then lastly, we're going to be adding it to a Divi form builder form module. Let's go and take a look. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is I found this library here called Canvas Confetti, which does a bunch of really cool stuff. It will do just like basic confetti when you click it, and it's pretty lightweight. It can do random directions, realistic looks, but it goes even further. It can do like different colors on the sides, can do different shapes. It can even do emoji confetti. I mean, this thing is actually quite crazy. It can really do a lot of different things. So it's going to be up to you how you want to utilize this. And this is the page, which I'll link in the description of this video, where you can go ahead and see how you can customize and apply these different effects. We mostly play with the different selectors here and then adding some classes to stuff to make it work correctly within Divi. And we're going to go from the easiest way to the more difficult way, but also probably the most useful way in my mind. So why don't we go ahead and take a look at how to do this with this Divi tutorial, because we're back, baby. Okay, so this tutorial is going to be taking advantage of some code snippets that we have available on the Divi engine website that will be linked in the description of this video, and it will have all the code you need to get this up and running on your Divi website. Now, I'm going to kick it off here with a page that I made that has the three different elements on the page so that we can kind of get a feel for how it's going to display on the page A, but then also, you know, just work in one space where you can have everything. And then if you want, I will probably also have these layouts available for download so that you can easily access them. Everything to be linked in the description of this video. So let's get cracking with this work. So do you need to install anything for this? No, nothing to be installed. We will be utilizing the library from a CDN, and that makes this life so much easier, doesn't it? So let's go ahead and enable this in the Visual Builder, and we're going to get started with just a plain button module. Now, with the button module, it is not super complicated to do this, but you do need to make sure that you add certain selectors to your button module. Now, I'm going to go here to the snippet that has all the information on there for you. So basically, the first thing you need to do is you just go ahead and add a .confetti button. Now, this class could be anything you want it to be if you want to do something fancy, make it look more bespoke for your clients, but we're just going to work with that. And I'm going to go on the button module. I'm going to go to the advanced tab. And then all we got to do here is in the classes, we'll add that confetti button class, of course, just without the period. And now you can still style this button any way you wish or want to, because all this happens through the magic of JavaScript. So it's not going to modify the look and feel of your button. It's just going to look awesome. So I'm going to go ahead and add that, and then we will get into the code. So I like to go, when I'm working with any type of code modules, to go ahead and go to the layout view, which means basically you can just kind of see all the modules on the page. And I'm going to go ahead and add a code module. All right. Now, just to keep this nice and clean, I'm going to say button module code, and I'm going to leave it at that. There's no classes or anything that you add here. And when we come back here to our snippets, the code is broken down into two parts. Now, I've also gone the extra length of heavily commenting this code for you, so you really know what each piece of the code is doing, but we'll have a chat about that as we go. But the first part you need to know is that we'll be adding this library from a CDN. So we can go ahead and just click this icon here that will copy the code. And this is kind of a new feature we're doing on the Divi engine side, by the way, too. It's just another value add for you guys, which is basically just adding very easy to use code snippets. So let's hop back here. And the biggest and most important thing you need to do is you need to make sure that it's between script tags, right? So the CDN that we're using is this JS deliver one. You can use any other one you wish. This is the one that worked for me. Now, when we think about like different places we can add the code, you can of course also go ahead and put this in your integration tab in the Divi theme options. And you can even go further and you can add it in your theme files. It's really up to you. But for the purposes of my demonstration, this is going to be the easiest because now we're also only loading the script on this page instead of every page where it might not be utilized. So I think that is a more efficient way of doing it. But hey, the world's your oyster. Do it the way you want to. So that's the first step. Now, this in itself is not going to do anything for you. You do need to go and add the additional code that's there. And here we can find the code for the button that's going to make that cool effect. Now, we can just go ahead and copy this. And then once I've copied it into that code module, we'll have a quick chat about what some of the stuff means and what's important to you. So our code's in there. And here we go. This first line is just, you know, it just says it's listening for the DOM content to be loaded. But then what we do is we go on the page with this line here. And this is the important part. We go and scan the document, the web page, to see if we can find the .confetti-button class. And it will, because we just added it to that button, right? And now, if you named it something else, of course, you're going to want to change this, right? And if you wanted to get more specific, if you, let's say, have multiple buttons on the page, you might want to add something additional maybe to that section so you can increase the specificity, that was tough to say, specificity of your selector here. But this will do for now and for our purpose here. And then when we go a bit further, we're just listening for a click on that element that we have selected. And then we go ahead and calculate its position. Now you can have the confetti come from wherever you want. I want it to come from the middle of my button. So that's why I've configured it. And this code here calculates the center of that button. And when we go a little bit further down, now here is where things, you might spend most of your time customizing things. So when we go back here and we look at the code here, you see that I just used this code here, but I modified it slightly to find the center of my button. Otherwise, I'd be in the center of the screen. So you would go ahead and set within your settings here. So when we come back here, when we're talking about the constant for the confetti settings, you would take that meat and potatoes in the middle. So these settings here, and then you would just go ahead and assign that to the confetti settings. It's as simple as that, nothing too crazy to do, but you would just put that in the middle and it should work fine. But of course, you know, you might have some trial and error with that. I am not going to mess with that right now, but you can check it out for yourself. Okay, cool. So that's basically the last part. It talks about the origin, and then this is just the trigger. It will do the confetti. So basically, it's taking everything here is what goes in the middle of those brackets. Now, like for this one, for example, you need to add an additional function within the JavaScript, and that would just go above this constant or below it or whatever. And that is how you skin this cat. All right, so let's go ahead and save this up. I'm going to go ahead and save my page, and then I will exit. Oh, I did not save it. So I'll just save and exit for simplicity. And then when I click it, simple as that, it happens, baby. Now, why is it doing this reload? Of course, because the button's going to either take you somewhere, trigger a action or anything like that. That would just mean that maybe you want to put a delay in there somewhere. So that's going to be up to you again. Just Google JavaScript delay and that will help you out there. But simple as that, we have it. Now, when I click another button, of course, nothing happens. Nothing happens because we haven't done anything. There's no code to associate with those. Okay, so number one, down. Awesomeness. Okay, so let's go back into our... Actually, let's first get out of this view and go out of the visual builder. Now, you know how we had to use a selector to find that class confetti button, and we added it to that button and in the code, that's all that fun stuff. So we need to also find out, okay, well, what's the class of the submit button? So maybe you're not going to do things the way that I'm doing it. You might want to put on something completely different. So all you really need to do is you need to come here, look at the element on the screen. And if I pull this down or up or left, there we go. Here we can see when I hover this, the button selected. So I just take that class ETPB contact submit because that's the submit button. And that will be our selector now. So let's go back into the visual builder. And now we will go ahead and not even edit anything here. We'll just go ahead and add a code module again. And then this time we'll say Divi form module code and go back to the text here. And now you guessed that we're going to go back to our snippet. So here is our Divi contact form snippet for this. And again, the code is exactly the same for calling that library. So you're going to go ahead and just place that back in there. So bam, that loads the library on the page. What, in all truth, you wouldn't need to do this right now because you might say, hey, Robey, but you have a code module up here. Were you calling this? Yeah, you're absolutely correct. You wouldn't need to do it again. But just so that we're not confusing people, I want to make sure that I show you that we're loading it for each element in case you're not going to have one of the other elements on the page. So there we go. That's done. So second part. And what we're going to do is I'm going to copy this code and then I'm going to go ahead and highlight the things that we've changed. Okay. So let's go ahead and go paste the code down here. There we go. I've got my code in here. And what is this code doing? Well, first thing we're doing, we're going and selecting that ETPB contact submit button that we just found by inspecting the front end and finding out what that submit button's code is or class is. And then what we're going to do is like, okay, cool. If it is a submit button, now this is because of the way that these elements are added on the page, because now we're dealing with forms and not just a straight button. So we're just making sure, is this a submit button? And then we're going to go ahead and add the class of confetti button. So we're sticking to confetti button. That minimizes the code we need to change down here. But again, if you change the confetti button class, you can change it to anything you want it to be. You can be more specific, you can be less specific, you can do whatever you want. Okay, so now we go, okay, well, if confetti button, okay, cool, we've added it. And then now we check to see for the event listener on click. And then we go ahead and we do the calculation again of what's the middle of where the button is. Then we go again with the particle counts. This is the same code as we had before. And you can adjust the amount of particles, you can the spread, the location. And as I mentioned before, you can play with the different settings for the particle counts and stuff like that. And then, you know, if there's extra functions or whatnot, you would just add those in outside of where you are defining the confetti settings. All right. All right. Cool. That's basically all we need to do. So I'm going to go ahead and save this up. And if I am predicting this correctly, we are going to have an issue on the page. And you'll see why in a second. So because I've got all of these on the same page, but let's test it. So I'm not going to fill out the form, but you see it didn't work. Why didn't it work? Because this is the first element on the page that has that class. So it's going to want to go to this one, but it's not detecting the click event, so it doesn't kick out the confetti. So how do we fix that? We just need to get a little bit more specific with our code. So if I come back here, and this is good for when you have multiple elements on the screen that you want to do this for. So let's go into the settings. All right. So to work on that specificity, we are going to add an additional class to the form within which our confetti button lives. So we'll open up the contact form module. We'll go to advanced. We'll go to custom CSS, CSS ID and classes, and add the class boom. Again, you can call that whatever you want, but you need to do this for this to work correctly. Now we'll go into the code module, and all we have to do is down here, nothing else changes, but here where we go document and the query selector, we want to select specific confetti button within our .boom class or whatever other element you might have this inside of. So if it's a blurb module, if it's a call to action, whatever the case might be, it needs to be on that parent element, okay? So let's save this up. Let's save our layout or page and exit. And now when I click this one, works as expected. And bam, when I click that one, it works as expected. And what's really cool is that it calculated exactly where the middle of that button is. So that is great stuff. You're not just stuck to one way of doing things. You can do it multiple ways, which is amazing. So number two down, this is going fast, very easy to do, and you are learning, which is great stuff. Okay, let's enable our visual builder again. And we're going to go to the last one here where I've got a form that kind of looks something like this. And when people click on the submit rating button, it is going to do the confetti kablooey. Now, the reason why this is going to be different than the contact form module, of course, because this is a completely different module. The Divi form builder module, which allows you to build fancy forms like this one. And we want to make sure that everybody gets to benefit from this. So scrolling down, we can already expect this. We're going to load the JavaScript and the specific library, the confetti.browser library. And I know here it says Canvas Confetti. It is just based on that. So it was ported over to that for the CDN. So just so you know. All right, so we're going to go down, 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 use our form. We already know that that submit button does not trigger the confetti, but we'll go ahead and add a code module and we'll just give it the name Divi Form Builder Code. just so we can differentiate between everything. And we'll just paste that library load in there. Again, you're not going to want to do this multiple times on the same page. It'd be a waste of resources as it's already been loaded on this specific page with the other two. But if it's the only confetti element you're going to have on the page, that's fine. If you have multiple, just load it once. Maybe you want to put this in a separate code module at the top of the page. And then, of course, another way, if you're going to be using this a lot on your site, you're going to want to add it in the integration tab within your Divi theme settings. Okay, so that's step one done. But of course, we already know that does nothing on our form. So we'll come back here to the article where I have the code conveniently located for you. And I'm going to copy it. And then what we'll do is we'll have a chat about what the differences are again. And they're not massive. So let me paste that in. And here we go. Again, the query selector here is the Divi form submit. Because why? Because same as we did with the previous one that we did. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and not add this code right now because I want to show you guys, because I think that's important in case you're skipping through the video. We want everybody to get the benefit. So I'm just going to save that up and then I'm going to exit the visual builder and scroll down here. Now, the way that you find the class you need to target, you're going to right click, you're going to inspect, you're going to open up the developer tools. And here we can see that the button is Divi form submit. Very simple, easy to know. And the type is submit, of course. So now this will work on like a multi-step form, all that fun stuff within Divi form builder. So a lot of yays right there. I'm going to close that out. We're going to go and enable the visual builder yet again. And now we're almost done. We're going to scroll on down. Now we know the code module is hiding there somewhere. So we're just going to go ahead and open up the module view, open up this code, and I'll just go and paste that code again so that it's in there. Cool. So now we know why we've got the Divi form submit as our query selector. Again, we're adding the confetti button class just to keep things simple, that you altering the minimal amount of code. And again, calculating the middle of the button. We're just making sure that we have the submit type button and all that fun stuff. And again, it's just a different setting. So it's really minimal changes you need to make for this to work correctly. So let's go ahead and save that. Now, if you followed along with the other one, with the contact form section of this video, you already know what's going to happen now, but I'm going to show you anyway. So we've got, boom, that one works. Boom, that one works. And boom, that one works. Why is that? Well, it is because there is only one desubmit button on this form. So that is lucky that it works. But the best practice here to do, of course, again, is I'm going to go into the visual builder and increase the specificity for the simple reason that there's multiple forms on this page, and it's just a good practice to do. So I'm going to go ahead and go to my advanced tab on the form itself, and I'm just going to call this form. Boom, this time. Oh, that's not how you spell form. There we go. I'm going to copy this class and save that up. And then we're going to jump into that code module again and put that right in front here of where we go and match the target. Cool. So there we go. I'm going to go ahead and save this, save and exit. And when I come down here, it still works with the specificity that we wanted. Now, you'll notice that when you scroll, it does kind of linger on the screen. Maybe in many cases, there'll be a bounding box, right? Like it would be an isolated amount of space people have to work in. So that's that. That is how easy and quickly you can go ahead and add these confetti effects. So any type of emoji effects, you can add snow, you can add stars. There's so much that you can do. You know, even I'm going to fold this in really quickly, but I can't even spell my name today. There we go. All right. And then we're just going to say service was okay. And I'm going to submit that and bam, there you go. Guys, it's been a pleasure. It's Robey from Divi Engine. Definitely encourage you to go check out Divi Form Builder. And if you haven't liked or subscribed to the page yet, what are you waiting for? All the links for all the code and all this stuff and many more resources in the description of this video. Head over to our blog where you can learn how to do some amazing things with Divi, and even one or two of our plugins. Our All Access Passes are out there, which gives you access to our entire library of tools. You know what? I just really appreciate it if you get in there and start building with our tools. Anyway, guys, it's been Robey with the Divi Engine team. It's been real. I'll catch you in the next video.